Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. On behalf of TechieTribe, I'd like to start our presentations with the introductions of Data Encryption Standard, DES. DES, or Data Encryption Standard, is the most popular block cipher for over more than 30 years. In 1972, U.S. National Bureau of Standards, NBS, undertook a modesty inventory, which is now called National Institutes of Standards and Technology, NIST. NBS began with a request for proposal for a standardized cipher in the USA to find a single secure cryptographic algorithm, which is very crucial for national security, that it had to be kept as a secret. In 1974, a group of IBM cryptographers approached the NBS with its algorithm that based on Lucifer. Lucifer is a physical cipher which encrypts blocks of 64 bits using a key size of 128 bits. NBS already requested the help of NSA, who later helps the alteration to the encryptions and re-christening the DES. Purportedly reported that NSA convinced IBM to reduce the key size to 56 bits, which made the cipher more vulnerable to the brute force attacks. We'll move to Ms. Nurhan Israya for more details about how DES works.
Thank you, Farah, for the general overview about the Data Encryption Standard. Now, we will go step by step individually and completely follow this entire process. I will start with step one, which is initial permutation, IP. Initial permutation happens only once before the first round of the step 2 begin, and what we do is we take the 64-bit block and we perform jugglery of bits position of the original plaintext. So what is actually happened in IP is we are performing transposition of bits, which means interchanging the positions. It suggests how the transposition in IP should proceed, and basically there are some criteria where we have already determined which bit position is being transposed. For example, the IP replaces the first bit of the original plain text block with the 50th bit and the second with the 50 bits, and so on. Once the process is done, the 64-bit block is divided into two blocks, which is LPT left plain text and RPT right plain text, and each of them are 32-bit blocks. Always remember, after IP is done, the 60 runs are performed, then the step 2 begin. The example diagram is just to demonstrate how initial permutation happens. As you can see, the input block of 64 bits position are swapped, and the output that we get is then divided into LPT and RPT. For the next step, I will let Hanim to explain about it.
In the key transformation stage, we will first begin with the removal of every 8 bit of the original key. In the ES, the original key used is actually a 64-bit key, as you can see in figure 2.1.1. But since we remove every 8 bit of the original key, this will result a new 56-bit key, as you can see in figure 2.1.2. Next, all the 56-bit key will be divided into two halves, both have an equal of 28-bit key each. Every bit on both halves will be circularly shifted to the left by one or two positions depending on the round. For round 1, 2, 9, and 16, shift will be done by only one position. And for the remaining round, which is round 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15, shift will be done by two positions, as you can see in figure 2.1.3. And lastly, compression permutation occurs where the 9th, 18th, 25th, 35th, 38th, 43th, and 54th bit is being dropped from the 56-bit key, resulting a new 48-bit key, as you can see in the table below.
Then we will move to Izati to explain the expansion permutation process.
Thank you, Hanim. So, now let's move on to step 2.2, expansion permutation. During the expansion permutation, the RPT is expanded from 32 bits to 48 bits. This operation expands the right half of the data R from 32 bits to 48 bits because this operation changes the order of the bits as well as repeating certain bits. This is known as an expansion permutation. In the first step of inscription during the initial permutation of this, the 64-bit plain text is permuted and we have 32 bits LPT and 32 bits RPT. Now, the expansion permutation is performed on the 32-bit RPT which transforms it from 32-bit to 48-bit. The 32-bit RPT is untouched during the process. For expansion, the 32-bit RPT is divided to 8 blocks, where each block is 4-bit. Each block of 4-bit expands to block of 6-bit, as you can see in the image below. This is an example image of the 32-bit RPT divide 8 blocks, where each block is of 4-bit. The extreme 2-bit of the block are repeated and the middle 2-bit is passed on as it is. After expansion, now the 48-bit RPT is XORed with the 48-bit key and the resultant 48-bit block is transferred to SBOT substitution. The next step will be explained by Farah Suraya.
The topic which I will explain now is SBOT substitution. This is the continuity to what Ms. Nurul Izzati taught earlier. Firstly, SBOT is the most important element of AES. The letter S for SBOT indicates the meaning of substitution, as SBOT functions to take the input value before transforming it into the new value. As we look at the diagram, the input value is 48 bits, which then it changed to 32 bits as the output. Look, how does it work? It happens when the 48 bits is divided to 8 parts. Turns out one part consists of 6 bits. Now we imagine the part are representing as S1 until S8, which each part has input value of 6 bits and the output value is 4 bits. Based on the diagram, we could see the output value from SBOT is 32 bits because we add and multiply those 4 bits to 8. We'll move to Ms. Nurul Izzati for more detail about PE box permutation.
Thank you, Farah, for the explanation just now. Permutation block is a method of a byte shuffling to transpose a byte across SBOT input. The output of SBOT was a 32 byte, our permit is simply block, so the output will be the same. Permutation means transposition, right? So, it involves a simple permutation that is swapping of each byte without any expansion. The output byte are just transposition of byte only. This is called basic p-block permutation or straight permutation. A straight p-block should have only one input for its output. The next step will be explained by Alisa.
First of all, I would like to thank Nurul Izzati binti Ibrahim for her explanation. So for my part, I will explain about the last step in step 2, which is the XOR and swap. As we can see, all along these operations, we only use the 32-bit write plain text, which is we call it as RPT. As we can see, the leaf plain text, we call it as LPT, was untouched. So in this process, the 32-bit LPT will be XOR with the output of the P box permutation. And the result of the XOR will become the new RPT for the next round. Okay, next, the old RPT here will be swapped with LPT and becomes the new LPT. We can say that the swapping process occurs here. So, for the next part, we will discuss more about the final step, which is the final permutation, and that will be explained by Nurhani Suraya.
Thank you, Alisa. So now let's move on to the step 3, final permutation, FP. After all the step 2 is over, the final permutation is performed only once. At the end of the step 2, We are getting 64 bits output, so we have the LPT and RPT, which gonna be 32 bits each, which divided by the 64 bits output from the step 2 that supplied to the final permutation. Again, final permutation performing a simple transposition with swapping of bits where we have 64 bits input. After performing transposition or interchanging bits position, we are going to get another output block of 64 bits. Therefore, by performing this final permutation, only then we are going to get the ciphertext. The output that we get from the final permutation is our actual ciphertext, and this is the end of the entire DES encryption process. Next, I will let Nurul to explain a little bit about Triple DES.
Thank you, Suraya, for the explanation just now. It known as the Triple Data Encryption Standard. This is because the three DES algorithm use that data encryption standard cipher three times to encrypt its data. 3DES was adopted in a wide range of applications. Some examples of its implementation include in Microsoft Office. There are many ways that encryption can be used in a modern application, including encrypting data in health, cloud, and forensic. For example, bot and ally should be able to communicate securely without finding out the content of their message, as in the figure 1. Private key or secret key encryption technique uses secret key which is known by the two communication parties, as in the figure 2. This key can generate by a base or can be passed from the two participants over a secure communication. First is to encrypt, and next to decrypt, and finally is encrypt. This system allows a key length of more than 128 bytes. A key is used in the first execution, then K2 is used, and finally K1 is used again. The last one will be delivered by exactly.
The conclusion is modern simplicity come into variant, which is block ciphers and stream ciphers, but the mostly block ciphers is used to be in DES and have proved to be very well designed block ciphers. DES is now considered to be insecure for some application. By adding additional key, modified SBOT design, modified function implementation, and replacing the OSOR by the new operation as proposed by this thesis to give more robustness to DES algorithm and make it stronger against any kind of intruding. In development process, public interest has also been demonstrated. Thank you.